Congressman Lagdameo, Congressman Nuño and I have been invited by the Senate to be part of the resource persons in this Senate meeting. Let me, for the record, no law passes if it does not pass the House of Representatives and the Senate. In fact, in all legislation, you can see senators and congressmen working together on vital legislative measures. So for us congressmen that are here, it is an honor and a privilege to be invited to this Senate hearing on the BBM. Having said that, I've always said in our congressional hearings that I am for peace. I am not anti-peace, but we need a BBM, Bangsar Borong Basic Law, that is just, that is fair, that is implementable or feasible. But most important, a BBM that is consistent with the Constitution and the existing laws. Having said that, the House of Representatives is already supposed to vote on Monday on the individual provisions. Each congressman and congresswoman has already submitted or more or less proposed individual amendments, revisions, additions, or deletions. For the record, I have gone through earlier in this meeting, I was working together with Congressman Del Rosario. We were looking at the consolidated draft. And for the record, I will tell you that I have 137 amendments or deletions or additions to the Bangsamoro Basic Law. But just to just concentrate on the issues that were taken up today. The issue of self-determination, which is in the preamble. More or less, I have even proposed a new section which involves the definition of terms. And in the definition of terms, I say internal self-determination shall refer to the people's pursuit of its political and economic, social, and cultural development within the framework of existing state and shall not be construed as a right to unilateral secession or declaration of independence. You see, you really have to make a difference between internal self-determination and external self-determination. What distinguishes the two is one, colonization, and that the rights and freedoms of the people are being suppressed. Unfortunately, that is found in the preamble. In the very preamble, it says recognizing the rights of the for self-determination, recognizing the struggle for freedom of the forefathers from past generation up to the present. If that is placed in the law, more or less it is now the Philippine government that is the one suppressing the rights. Also, in the definition of terms, as I mentioned earlier, we are proposing contiguous areas shall refer to land areas which are adjoining or adjacent to each other. Water and contiguity by air does not apply. Para malinaw. Okay. In the issue of the joining, the territory. In letter D, it says, all contiguous areas where there is a resolution of the government unit, the petition is then protected. In the House, I have proposed that we delete areas and instead of areas, put six provinces and cities to make it clear that it is not any local government unit, but it can only be provinces and cities joining the
Bangsamoro.
As such, we have proposed the deletion of the opt-in joining any bank. That we are proposing to delete. We are also proposing to delete inland waters. Why? Because, as stated in the position of water meeting, inland waters should be the same for all municipal government. It should be 15 kilometers and not 22.2. Further than that, talking about the constitutional issues, it is our proposal, my proposal, that we put now energy into the reserve powers of government. Not only energy, national, regional, and local elections, auditing, civil service, human rights, quarantine, and land and air transportation. In effect, we are proposing, I am proposing to remove under the concurrent powers, quarantine, auditing, civil service. Now, we also are proposing for the deletion of that section brought out by Congressman Cayetano on the exclusive powers of the Bangsamoro for them to have the right to regulate power generation, transmission, and distribution, as we are now proposing that this be now put under the powers of the national government. Now, there is also a provision in the intergovernmental relations that allows the Bangsamoro to extend assistance to communities outside the Bangsamoro. We are proposing that the national government should really help all the Bangsamoro communities, but it should be done the National Commission of Muslim Filipinos and not the Bangsamoro. That is the mandate of the National Commission of Muslim Filipinos. Anything to do with elections has to be with the national government. Why? You see, there was the debate, there was the discussion earlier. But under the BBM, there is section 9 that says Bangsamoro Electoral Code, that says Bangsamoro Transition Authority shall enact the Bangsamoro Electoral Code. There is hereby created the Bangsamoro Elective Office, which will be part of the Commission of Complex, and which shall perform the functions of the Commission. COMELEC is a constitutional body. Congress cannot legislate what a constitutional body can do or should do. So, in fact, if you look at the functions of the Bangsamoro office, it will register and accredit political, regional political parties in relation to the plebiscite for joining the Bangsamoro, receive petitions. These are petitions from areas outside the Bangsamoro. So why should the Bangsamoro be the one to receive the petition? Schedule the plebiscite for expansion. That should be common. And then it says prepare rules and regulations for the Bangsamoro election. It should only be common that should prepare the rules and no regional office. So, and then when it comes to issue of SPDA, we are proposing to delete that section of the SPDA and put this is together with Congresswoman Lidia Nuño. It says all lands and permanent buildings or structures owned belonging to the SPDA located in provinces and cities not forming part of the Bangsamoro shall be transferred, sold, conveyed, donated to local government units wherein these properties are located and have signified intention of the same. Again, in the other sections, we are also proposing under economy and patrimony the deletion of the zones of joint cooperation that was brought earlier. Also, the deletion of the body of zones of joint cooperation, and also section 20 to delete the section of the exploration, development, utilization of non-living sources in the zones of joint cooperation, and also to delete the section of inland waters. Concerning the plebiscite under Article 15, this is the plebiscite to join OPIN anytime. Again, we are proposing to delete it. And then, very important, especially for Zamboanga City, there is the provision under Republic Act 1954 that says any government, all properties located in areas that are outside the armed should be purchased by the national government and sold to the local government. We are proposing that that be now retained in the BPL law. So, again, you can see that Conference Board Lilian Julio and I are working to make sure that we are fighting for the interests of Huanca City, doing what is best for Mindanao, upholding the Constitution and protecting the Republic. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.